In this lecture, we would talk about how to interpret the results of process capability analysis and how to narrow down to improvement strategies based on that. We would now start looking at the steady capability indices like CP/CPK, PP/PPK, and all that stuff. So let's start by comparing the CPK value with the PPK value. Ideally, the difference between the CPK value minus the PPK value tells us what is the long-term improvement potential in the process. Very similar to what I explained to you about expected variation or expected defect versus expected within. How we can eliminate things like shifts, drifts, and all those special causes and improve our process. In our case, you look at the CPK and PPK value. So we are talking about very less potential for improvement because the red curve and the dotted black curve are almost same. If these curves were different from each other, then this potential would have been high as well.